Well, the first difficulty is really so simple that it's usually overlooked. To be a Negro in this country, and to be relatively conscious, is to be in a state of rage almost all of the time. And in one's work, and part of the rage is this: it isn't only what is happening to you, but it's what's happening all around you and all of the time, in the face of the most extraordinary and criminal indifference of most white people in this country, and their ignorance. Now, since this is so, you know, it's a great temptation to simplify the issues under the illusion that if you simplify them enough, people will recognize them. Mm-hmm. I think this illusion is very dangerous because, in fact, it isn't the way it works. You know, a complex thing can't be made simple. You simply have to try to deal with it in all its complexity.
I think what you're trying to ask is, why am I so insistent upon giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with black culture, outside and inside. And to me, we have a culture that is surpassed by no other civilization, but we don't know anything about it. My job is to somehow make them curious enough or persuade them by hook or crook to get more aware of themselves and where they came from and what they are into and what is already there, and just to bring it out. This is what compels me to compel them.
That was all about the revolution will not be televised. That was about the fact that the first change that takes place is in your mind. You have to change your mind before you change the way you live and the way you move. That the thing that's going to change people is something that no one will ever be able to capture on film. It'll just be something that you see, and all of a sudden you realize, I'm on the wrong page, or I'm on the right page, but I'm on the wrong note. And I've got to get in sync with everyone else to understand what's happening in this country. Uh-huh. But I think that the black Americans have been the only real diehard Americans here, because we're the only ones who've carried the process through the process, that everyone else has sort of like skipped stages. We're the ones who marched, we're the ones who carried the Bible, we're the ones who carried the flag, we're the ones who tried to go through the courts. And being born American didn't seem to matter, because we were born Americans, but we still had to fight for what we were looking for, and we still had to go through those channels and those processes.